Hello guys, today continue apologetics as attorney. So in the last video, we in the part where we are in the courtroom where Christoph Gavin is the witness. Load 3. Coincidence. Christoph did try to slip out from under this accusation by changing the subject. If that's not bluffing, what it is? What is it? Why do they have two claims here? I could ask you the same question, Christoph. I silence the defense with the fewest word possible. It's called efficiency. But Mr. Gavin, that's impermissible testimony. Very well, I shall take his claim head on then. Yes, please. What? You accuse me of Rumisha murder, yes? Then allow me to ask you, what possible reason could I have to kill a painter? Apollo! Motive! He's talking about a motive! Indeed. It's hard to see how an attorney could come to want to kill a painter. Now here's something, why didn't he bring up the motive from the very beginning? Unless he was afraid it was a battle he might lose. So what does it mean? It means there might be a weak spot. Maybe I have some evidence to prove a motive. I do. A motive for murder. This is a vital, if not the most vital element in this case. Please consider this when making your statement. Oh no. No, my head bar. I say it's about this vital. That's pretty vital. Oh, Mr. Justice, I'm going through with this no matter what. Understood, Your Honor. I like to present evidence. Then let's see what you have for us. What reason did Christoph Gavin have to one thing? To murder Drew Ham. Present? Christoph Gavin's motive becomes clear when we consider why the stamp came to Drumisham's studio in the first place. And why was that? Forgery, Your Honor! Go back 7 years, Drumisham accepts his first job plating forged evidence. I've seen that before. A page from a diary, wasn't it? Magnificent Gamer's diary. Did Mr. Rai request the forgery be made? That was never proven. Objection! The defense attorney on that case was Phoenix Wright. Who other than him drunk with the prospect of victory could have done it? And where were they? This all crazy. Do you remember this letter? This is the first page. Presented in the court yesterday. This letter was sent to Domitian by the client who requested the forgery. The in-cross stamp was none other than for the poison commemorative stamp. Domitian drew his last breath just the other day. However, the motive for his murder was already 7 years old. 7 years old? The client who requested this forgery was very cautious. He tried to erase anything and anyone with connections to the forgery to keep them from talking, but he made a mistake. The stamp was a picture of my favorite magician, so I kept it. Father took me when I was very young. It was a great magic show. I love it very much. The killer's time bomb was delayed. The poison stamp was sealed with a glass frame. But it sat for 7 whole years. Your forehead, understand what you're telling us. The one who came up to the forged diary was the one who poisoned the stamp. And it was Phoenix Wright who presented the forged evidence 7 years ago. Adding the two statements together, the one who came to kill Drew Misham was none other than Phoenix Wright. Sorry, but that's not how this is going to go down. Oh, then how will it go down? I checked through the records on that case when I found this. 7 years ago, just before the trial began. Oh, oh boy! Here! What's this? I don't know, I just got it over there in the hall. They told me to give it to the old boy in the blue suit with the spiky hair. And one more thing. On the case the day before the trial started. He didn't have time to request a forgery. The day before? Now here's the question. This was the Enigma previous defense attorney. No, this can't be all. But it is all true. Was another man, a defense attorney with a badge on his collar. It was you, Christoph Gavin! Order! What is the meaning of all this, witness, I mean defendant, a former lawyer? Let me begin by denying this.
Objection!
It is enough to look up Mr. Gavin, and impossible to prove if you can. Attorney are registered with the court the day before the trial begins. In other words, no record remains in the court. How exactly did you intend to prove Phoenix Wright claim? That would be difficult. I'm afraid different of inquiry won't yield.
Objection!
Here forehead, are you sure you don't have evidence? What's wrong with Prosecutor Gavin? He looks clammy! Evidence! Evidence that show this man Christoph Gavin requested that forgery 7 years ago. Clavier? Just prove it! Clear up those doubts now, or I swear I'm off this case. He must have some evidence, Apollo. Secretary Gavin looks like he's in physical pain. That darkness. I have to pull that darkness out of him, and prove it's the only way I can. Was Christoph Gavin linked to Drew Misham? Well, Mr. Justice, you claim Christoph Gavin committed forgery of Drew Misham 7 years ago. Prove it. It can be proven. Simply ridiculous. Why even discuss it? This evidence does not.
Objection!
Are you telling the truth, Apollo Justice? I am. Then I say we give him the benefit of the doubt. Very well, but if you're wrong about this, be prepared for a penalty. No.
Objection!
Your Honor, you do the defense and an injustice. If the justice is clearly passionate about his claim, should the penalty not match his passion? I haven't given a penalty like that in a long time. Well, Mr. Justice? Fine, Your Honor. All I have to prove is any kind of link. Something that ties Christoph Gavin to Drew Misham. Safe. Let me safe. Show us the link between our witness and Drew Misham. do you have fear? It looks like a person thinking about something. Maybe they worry? Like, what should I have for? A supper, a hot dog, or a hamburger? You know, I always wondered about that. Why is there supper and dinner? Are they different meals or the same thing? Maybe that's what this person thinking about. This?
Take that!
This evident proof there's a bling.
Objection!
Oh, am I wrong? Okay, I was right. I was like, oh my god, am I wrong? That's Daddy handwriting. Mr. Red handwriting? What is the meaning of this? I see now. Yes, of course. What do you mean, of course? I just remembered I had a visitor yesterday. Mr. Red came to my cell, except I wasn't there. Mr. Red. When I returned, I saw he had something of mine in his possession. Of course, I had no intention of letting him get away with reading my private mail. Mail? You mean this letter was in your cell? No. However, it appears Mr. Wright has yet to be cured of his bad forging habit. Well, if it's forgery, it's not a very good one, the handwriting's terrible. This is Mr. Wright's reproduction of what was written in the real letter. Reproduction? When Mr. Wright visited Christoph Gebbing's cell, he brought with him a small video camera. What? He records his entire conversation with you, Mr. Gavin. And the content of your personal mail. Regardless, this mockery of a pane of evidence will never be accepted by the court. Evidence based on a video, a man with no authority whatsoever claim he took. A man who happens to be an ex-attorney suspected of forgery? Prosecutor Gavin. Prosecutor Gavin? As embarrassing as this is for me to say, I'm afraid my brother is incapable of making rational judgments at the moment. Your Honor, your decision please. Defense claim is denied. What? Unnatural evidence is permitted in the court of law. Please remove the defense evidence from the record. No! Good luck next time, Justice. Well, we certainly take an edict from our cross-examination, where the defense appears to be lacking proof. I'm forced to end the cross-examination of Christoph Gavin at this point. Hello! Do something! I don't know! I'm thinking, but without evidence, I don't have anything I can use on him. Very well, this ends with special witness cross-examination.
Objection!
This show's over, yet the crowd screams for more. Only now do I understand why. Is it Peter Gavin? Frankly, I'm relieved. This has been bothering me for 7 whole years. And I'm tired of the whole youthful angst scene. Now's our chance. Let's clean out the family closet, eh, Christoph? Xavier, you're spinning out of control. Calm yourself before you say something you regret. Spinning out of whose control? Mine or yours? Take a moment to consider everything you've built. Your reputation as a prosecutor, your fame with the masses. You could lose it all, Clavier. Hola! Did you see that? He's trying to press prosecutor Gavin! aku tergiving. Try to remember what's really important to you. You amuse me here, forehead. I can't forget what's really important to me even if I try. In fact, I haven't, not even once. 7 years ago. Finally, you just couldn't resist, could you hear right? Resist what? Presenting solid evidence? My request we put the current cross-examination on hold. The prosecution would like to call a new witness. State your name and occupation for the record. I'm familiar with the trial. I watched the video several times. Did you find anything unnatural about it? Unnatural? Well, you did seem unusually well prepared. I mean, Mr. Wright had only just presented his evidence. And the next moment you call in Drew Misham. It was almost as if... Almost as if what? Funny, it didn't even occur to me to wonder. But now that I do, I see there's only one possible explanation. Almost as if from the very beginning, you knew Mr. Wright was going to present that evidence. Quick! I knew that if I applied the usual pressure, Phoenix Wright would eventually come up with that forged diary page. Don't do this, Clavier. I knew because you told me, Christoph. The night before the trial. Clavier. Christoph? Oh, seeing you at the prosecutor's office the day before the trial. I won't be appearing in the trial actually. Huh? Why not? I won't be facing off with you on the first trial apparently. But in exchange, I got information. Information? Who be there in my place tomorrow is not to be trusted. Don't even give him the benefit of your respect, listen. I want you to call him a special witness. Then, I wondered about it at the time. How did Christoph know so much? Secretary Gavin? Christoph, we were supposed to face each other in that trial. A fair fight, brother to brother. I deserve that much. Show me all your research on the case. The victim's belonging? It should have included McNiff's diary. Wouldn't it? Mr. Gavin? My Clavier, you disappoint me. You find trees yet miss the forest. You're the one missing the forest, Mr. Gavin. You can't sweep this under the rug, not anymore. Tell me what was going on behind that trail. Why not? I've achieved what I came here to do. I see no harm in a little reminiscing. Apollo! I think we're finally going to shine light on the black belly of this thing, Tracy. We've done everything we could. I hope it's enough. 7 years ago, the day before the trial, I visited the detention center at the request of my client, Zed Gamery. I don't know what his reason were to this day. As far as I could tell, he dismissed me as his representation because I lost in a game of poker. I can come to no other conclusion. Maybe he used to say something. If you want to know a man, you have to compete. Jake wasn't watching. He's point on the cards. He was watching the man behind the cards, Christoph Gibbons. I can't believe it. Phoenix Wright, a second rate attorney who relies on luck and bluff. He dismissed me and went with that pitiful excuse for a man. He deserves to die for that error alone. So basically, your ego is hurt. Okay. Hold it. So the one who requested that forgery was... I'm not admitting anything. My point is, this man shamed me and I could not forgive that. Phoenix Red and Jack Gamery both deserve what they got. So you ask Mr. Mitchell to forge that evidence so you could win. But then, when you were dismissed as the Gamery's attorney, you used your forged evidence as a trap. You fed me information about the forgery you made. Then you gave your dirty evidence to him. You are free to imagine what you will. My point is that all I had imagined came to pass. Everything went perfectly. So basically, you are kinda admitting. Incredible. If I wasn't laughing, I weep. So, Secretary Gavin? Perfectly. You're mad, Christoph Gavin. Stop fooling yourself. What are you talking about, Clavier? Tell me, how did that trial end? Cancelled when the defendant finished. Ah, I get it. So, Christoph, you've been living in fear for 7 years. What? You were afraid your forgery would be revealed and your reputation trashed. You couldn't leave things to chance. So you watched everyone involved with the case for 7 years. You know, he always felt like he was being watched. That's what he said every day for 7 years. But I feel too, generally sure he is being watched and caught. Don't you wonder why Jack got robbed after 7 years? Right after coming into contact with me? Wait just a minute. Jack Gamery was seen by this reporter? How is that possible? Was he alive after being gone 7 years? Finally, I knew this moment was coming. I just didn't think we'd get here so fast. Jack Gamery gone missing for 7 years, trusty fathers. What's wrong, Apollo? Go get him! Right, leave it to me. Allow me to refresh the court's memory. 6 months ago, Christoph Gavin was charged with murdering a mysterious traveler. I remember him quite well. Chinese meat, was it? Poison in a Chinese restaurant, Haji. Russia, I remember. Details don't really matter right now. What matter is that traveler was the Gamery. What is it, Apollo? Huh? Keep going! We talk about it later! Did she already know? Okay, that's it for today's guys. Bye-bye!